Teen angel, teen angel, teen angel. That fateful night, the car was stalled upon the railroad track. I pulled you out and we were safe, but you went running back. Teen angel, can you hear me? Teen angel, can you see me? Are you somewhere up above? And am I still
very electric? And it's the essence of puberty.
The movement in the pictures. Even though we're looking at flat objects, you can see a lot of movement. You can see the story in the pictures.
It's good. I like the colors a lot. It's all the emotion.
It's one of the most exciting uses of gallery space I've seen in the Well Center. It's really unusual to see sculptural installations and paintings mixed and to create a whole environment like she does. It's really neat. I hope it encourages other artists.
I think it's pretty powerful. I really really enjoy it. There's a lot of parts about it that remind me of when I went through a lot of problems with my father, and so it's a way to let me kind of laugh at my past too. I really like it.
I guess I like the sensitivity and the passion that has gone into it. And the best picture that I like, I have several.
It's my wife in her work. I remember the convertible date getaway and the window, except her sneak out window was my throw the beer out window.
Oh, love it. It's so vibrant, so colorful. It's just like a constant stimuli over and over and over. Makes me really wonder what's always going through Louie's mind as she's doing the work. And I know the one piece over here is talking about that, but the rest of these makes me want to talk to her about them.
I lived in a pink house from the time I was 9 to 16 years old. My father painted this house bright pink and the roof a turquoise blue, which I called swimming pool blue. I hated this house. It caused me frustration and embarrassment. Before the house was built, my father also brought in extra dirt to our property to make our yard higher than the neighbor's so it would drain better. In these paintings, you will see how I use the height of the ground as a way to intensify the drama of some paintings. The two green posts that are seen in many of the paintings were made by my father. He took two 12-inch cannon balls, welded them to two solid steel posts, and buried them in deep cemented holes on each side of a small suburban driveway with a chain from one to the other. They became a real challenge when I had to learn to drive a car. My father thought it best that my first driving lesson should be in a 2-ton truck. His reasoning was that I could drive a truck. If I could drive a truck, I could drive a car. This truck was a construction site yellow in color and was also his welding shop on wheels that he took to drag strips each weekend. I realized that fitting the truck between the steel posts would be a tremendous task for an inexperienced driver. Fear would shoot through my body each time he insisted on me performing this task. In some paintings, these posts transform into other objects such as maracas and balloons. In schizophrenic drama, I am painting about my recurring nightmare of sliding down a razor blade mountain. I would always have to climb one side and then be forced to decide how I would slide down the razor blade side by some unknown dark force. Sometimes I let it slice me perfectly in two. Other times I would put my face to one side or the other. In later years, I realized I was being spiritually split in two by my parents' arguments and fights. Not everything was bad then, even though I wished my dream parents would find and save me from it all. My mom also grew marigolds, which I liked for their strength, color, and slightly clean medicinal smell. Once I even won a first place for her flowers in grade school with a bouquet of her giant marigolds. So I've painted her marigolds with cabbage butterflies. On one of my trips to Mexico, I discovered that marigolds are used in Mexico's Day of the Dead celebration to light the path for loved spirits to return. I have also painted about a shirt she sewed for me. I would always wear whatever she made me. I appreciated her efforts on my behalf, even if it made me shrink inside, which was the case with this certain shirt. It had an outrageous orange and green 1-inch checkered pattern, and when I wore it outside, I could feel the orange and green checks next to the bright pink and swimming pool blue house. So for this show, I dedicated these colors as my theme colors. At the age of 13, my father put my 10-year-old dog to sleep when Mom took us kids to see her parents for several weeks. So the crucifixion of Bootsy is about my grief over the loss of a special friend that I was not able to say goodbye to. Full Moon Emergency reveals the memory of my brother almost losing his life to fire when trying to get the garage potbelly stove warmer for our dog on a very cold winter night under a real full moon. Aurora Borealis shows how our house shows it as different from the neighbors. It stuck out like a sore thumb, and its colors glowed far and wide. I could see it from a hill almost 2 miles away. There is a small drama of our dog protecting our cat from a neighbor's dog in the lower part of the painting. As a teenager, my sexual drives were strong, and I believed I used this force as a way to prove my worth or to forget the hurt at home. Convertible Date Escape, Pink House Breakthrough, and Pink House Reproduction are all works that play with my early attempts at being sexually desirable. Pink House Warrior is the first painting I did that shows my acceptance of the past. When painting this, I recognize that I have finally embraced the parent-induced shame I suffered and my self-inflicted shame. In this painting, I am both protector and nurturer of my youthful difficulties and of who I am and was. From there, I have painted Pink House Power, which is the result of my transcendence into the joy of my survival and individualism and my spiritual awakening. This show has other works I have not mentioned, but feel that I have done enough to explain my efforts. I am still compulsive about the Pink House series and have more work to do in the future. I am grateful to my greater spirit for allowing me the opportunity to find meaning in my life and to be able to make the unknown known.
My brother, my nephew.